VOCALOID.
Hey everybody, Josh Bess here. In this video, I'll create a robot lead vocal with VOCALOID 5. So I have this new VOCALOID 5 project open, and I'll set the tempo to 140 to speed this up a bit. And I'll add an audio track and bring in some music to work with. All right, and I want to create two different vocal parts for this vocal phrase. So I will drag this smaller for two bars and then draw in another two bars over here. And I'll change the names to part one and part two. And then I'll draw some notes in. And okay, and I'll write in some lyrics. You are my only one. I'll move the Lee over here. And one. And since I divided the word only into two separate words, essentially, the word Lee now sounds like lie. So I'll simply change the word to Lee.
Lee.
And this will make it sound like the full word only now. And I'll do the same thing for part two. I'll draw out some notes and write in some lyrics. All right, and now I'll add some style and effects to this singer. So I'll head into the style tab, and there's tons of style presets I can choose from, although I'll create a very digital and robotic type of sound. So I'm going to choose bouncing. Yeah, you can hear this is a huge difference. It has a really strong vocoder type of effect going on, creating this robot type of vocal effect. And I do like the way this sounds, although I will jump into the customize section and edit this a bit to make it feel a little more like a natural singer, although still keeping that digital robot kind of vibe going on. Although I will change the robot voice setting to the strongest setting, creating harder cuts between each note. I'll bring down the character a bit to deepen the voice. I'll close the mouth a bit to shorten and soften the notes. And I'll also bring some of these audio effects down a bit to hear more of the dry vocal. And I'll add some reverb to this as well. And the volume's a bit low, so I'll raise the gain a bit as well. I can also adjust this further with the mixer. All right, now I'll edit part two, and I'll keep this pretty similar to part one, although I'll make it slightly different by adjusting some of the parameters. All right, and with some slight mixing, this is what we have.